So today I want to share with you a dish that I have been making for about 10 years now, and I've changed it about 100 times along the way. Today I'm calling it BLT pasta because I'm using bacon, leaf parsley, and tomato. It's very similar to spaghetti carbonara, and I'm just adding a few ingredients. I hope you're able to give this a try and adjust it to whatever ingredients you have it growing in your garden. So I'm going to grab some beefsteak tomatoes. Paste tomatoes would be very good. Anything that has a little bit of meat to it. I'm also going to use some of the smaller cherry tomatoes. Well, actually I'm using what are called yellow pear tomatoes, but I'll show you that in a minute. Now, you're not going to need a lot of tomatoes for this, but I'm grabbing all of these because, well, they're ready to be picked. And then over here I have some red onions. These are called flat of Italy. I get the seeds at rareseeds.com. And here are the little yellow pear tomatoes. So I'll go ahead and put that in here too. And then out in my container garden, I have some flat leaf Italian parsley. So that will go in the pasta as well. Now you are welcome to do a screenshot for the ingredients here. This is enough for 2 servings. And so it's real easy to put together. It might look like a lot of ingredients here, but it really doesn't take much time at all. I'm using angel hair pasta because it's thinner, it cooks a little quicker. Of course, you can use a thin spaghetti too. So here's just a closer look at our ingredients. I have, of course, the angel hair pasta, about 8 ounces of tomatoes, the parsley, I think basil would be good too, the red onion, shallots are also wonderful, some fresh eggs, some olive oil, some black pepper, salt, and some Pecorino Romano cheese, along with some bacon. And I get the cheese and the bacon at a place called Trader Joe's. So I just rough chopped the tomatoes. I went ahead and fried the bacon and crumbled it, and then reserved the bacon drippings, which I'm going to use. And I finally grated the cheese and then chopped the parsley and minced the onion. And now we're ready to go. And I didn't mention earlier, but I'm using a little bit of garlic. So I'm using about 1 clove minced of garlic, which I have in olive oil here. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So I want to crack my eggs. I want 1 whole egg and then just the yolk of the 2nd egg. So I'll go ahead and beat these together, and then we want to go ahead and add some salt and some black pepper. A lot of black pepper is really good in this too, so don't be shy on your black pepper. And then we'll add our cheese. I left a little bit aside for the final dish, but most of the cheese went right in here. Now I'll set this aside, and in the pan that I fried the bacon in, I want to go ahead and put in about 2 tablespoons of the bacon grease along with the minced onions. And I'm on about medium low heat to medium heat. I want to get these onions sweetened up, and they're looking pretty good at this point. And now I'll add 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And I'll go ahead and add my bacon. At the same time, I have my pasta water going in the background. So I'm cooking my pot. I haven't added the pasta yet, but I have the water going and it's ready for me to add. It'll only take a few minutes for that. So I went ahead and added the garlic as well. And I'm still on about medium low heat. I went ahead after about 1 minute and then reduced that heat down to low, just as low as it would go. And in go my tomatoes. I don't really want to cook my tomatoes too much. I just kind of want them to start to release some liquid here. And so I'll just go ahead and toss them here in this warm oil on low heat and until they're soft. So after a few minutes, they've started to soften up. I went ahead and added most of the parsley, and I have just a little bit more to add at the end. All right, it looks pretty good. The tomatoes, I don't want them to get overcooked. So I went ahead, turned off the heat, and removed them aside. And now my angel hair pasta is ready. So into my pan it goes. Everything is still very hot, piping hot. And what we want to do is just go ahead and add the pasta directly from the water. We'll just go ahead and give this a nice toss here. Thank you. And now into the egg it goes, along with a tiny bit more pasta water. I don't want it to be too tight, so I want it to kind of be loosened up here. And it was looking really nice. Nice and creamy, just wonderful. So on top, I put a little bit more of that parsley, and into our serving dish it goes. It's very, very flavorful. I promise you will make this more than one time. And so right there on top, a little bit more cheese. You can add as much cheese as you want to. And then I grabbed a few of the sweet pea currant tomatoes just as a little garnish, and it was just delicious. I know that you will absolutely love this dish. And if you have any questions about it, leave them below the video and I'll be more than happy to help you. I hope you enjoy it. And if you want some more ideas for recipes, please feel free to head on over to my channel where I have a lot more ideas for ingredients that you might be growing in your garden. And don't forget to click that little bell off to the right of the subscribed button and you'll receive all notifications for my channel. Thank you so much for watching and y'all have a beautiful day.